George?
Here.
Patricia?
Here.
Jesse?
Yo.
Joseph? Joseph? Has anyone seen Joseph? No?
Yeah, he hasn't been to school for like 3 days.
All right, it's Halloween. I trust you guys. I gotta take my kids trick-or-treating. So I'm just gonna leave you here to the bell, all right? All right?
Yeah. All this sucks.
Why are they making us stay in school right now?
There's nothing more fun than a mid-afternoon Halloween party.
And nothing scary about it either.
I got a story.
Oh, we're doing scary stories now, huh?
Well, this one doesn't take place in the dark. This happened, actually, around this time of day. I want to say about 300 years ago. There was this group of people. I think they called themselves, the Wise Men. They met very frequently, about 3 times a week for quite a long time, in complete secrecy. No one knew exactly what they did, but they were seen very rarely. The only way somebody would know about it was if a member spoke.
What, so some kids dressed up and formed an after-school club?
No, this wasn't some extracurricular activity. They did more than just meet on Thursdays. This group has been around for a very long time, even before the school was built. Every new generation elected new leaders, as if they had their own form of government. One thing was very vital to the group. Don't say a word. Never spoken, never happened.
So how do you know all of this?
Hold on, I'll get to that.
Now, it's been 30 years since word of the wise men has been tossed around. Back in the 90s, a pretty big story came out. It was today, 1991. The club had been on a hiatus for a little while. Word came about that they were getting the band together again. One of the new guys decided he wanted to tell someone about it. His most grave mistake. Now, as I said, confidentiality and silence are this club's mantra. There's going to be some punishments for your actions. They had this ancient ritual to silence the kids who spilled the beans. When they found out, they knew they had performed the ritual once again. They left a giant scar on his face. An X. Just like this. It's not 3 strikes when you're out here. It's like the umpire doesn't know the rules or something. This kid was kicked out, never to show his scarred face in front of these people again.
Every generation there's bound to be a tattletale. Who's to say we don't have one in this generation?
Okay, are you guys gonna listen or just play games?
I'm not listening to a story about a fake cult or whatever. Your futile attempts to scare us are just sad.
Just listen, alright? It gets good. Now, this kid, obviously angry, not only after getting his face diced like an onion, but now he's not allowed back in. So, he's gotta find a way back, right? Well, you remember Mr. Thompson? Believed the earth was flat, crazy conspiracy guy. Died that Thursday in a car crash on his commute home. Sounds like an innocent accident, right? Well, let me ask you this. How does an ex-member of the Wise Men redeem himself? He believed if he silenced Mr. Thompson, he could get his ticket right at the door.
Sorry.
God, right at the climax, too. Anyways. Today marks the 30th anniversary of the incident. The story goes that every 30 years, on the 31st of October, it happens again at 3 p.m.
So what happens at 3 p.m.?
Well, if you ask me... Nothing. Yeah, Joseph told me that story. He told it so well, he almost had me believing it was real.
Wait, so is this Joseph's story?
Yeah, he used to blab on about this stuff all the time. He's obsessed. Started to sound like Mr. Thompson with all his conspiracy talk. Sometimes he went pretty far with it. Loved to shout, 3 p.m., 3 p.m. at me all the time.
Dude, where are you going? It just got interesting.
because I was about to write anyway. Great story, though. Hey, man, why'd you lock it? Let me out!
All right?
You're sorry now.